Hello everybody. Today's video is inspired by another video that I watched, Happy Homework. I'm pronouncing my H's there so there's no confusion. And the title of the video was How to Reuse Plastic Bags DIY, Plastic Bags Reuse Ideas Best Out of Waste. There is a link because that's quite a lengthy title. But it's a really good video because, like everybody I suppose, I have a mountain of carrier bags that I never use. I do a lot of shopping at Iceland, you can tell. Get the home deliveries a lot as well. Now, in the original video that I saw, she uses more the crinkly sort of plastic bags, but I find that these bags are much thicker. But I've still got the same problem. They never get reused because it's impossible to reuse all these bags. Now, in the video, she made rope out of them, and I've been making it as well. I'm going to show you how to make it. She did it a slightly different way to how I did it because I'm too impatient the way she did it, so my way is a bit faster. And a bit of a fun fact, up until I made this, I'd never braided anything before. This is my first attempt. And what you can do is, these big knots here, they'll be explained later, but they're usually at regular intervals until I got better practice, really, really quite strong. And we're going to find out how strong it is because I've got a way of measuring how strong this carrier bag rope can be. This way you can make the rope as long as you want. Also, what colour you want as well, because I shop at Iceland, so mine is this lovely beige sort of colour, so it's not in your face. But if you want some brightly coloured rope, you could maybe, if you shop regularly at Wilkinson's, you get that lovely deep red colour, which might look a bit posh, like a red velvet rope at an event or something. You can make orange carrier bag rope with Sainsbury's carrier bags, and so on and so on and so on. This is my second attempt, which is much longer, just to demonstrate that you can just go on forever, and it's really, really therapeutic in a sort of way, and once you get into it, it's really easy to do. The first step of what you need to do is to make loads and loads of strips of carrier bag, of which I have conveniently lost. In fact, I might not have lost them, I might have actually used them, because it's actually, once you get started, it's difficult to stop. What you do is you get your old carrier bags, and what you need to do is to make ribbons out of them. Make sure that the carrier bag is as straight as you can get it, because if you've had them shoved away in a drawer, they may have got a bit creased up and whatnot, but it's not too much of a problem. The first thing you need to do is snip off the ends, the handles. Now, for the purposes of what I did, I didn't want too many red bits in my rope, so I actually wasted this bit. But if you're not too fussed about it, you can keep that bit. But I chopped it off anyway because I didn't want too many red bits. I wanted my rope to look as uniform as possible. And you usually get about 4 to 5 strips. And what we've done here though is a big loop of plastic. And I'll just easily, quickly demonstrate. Look, that's 1, 2, 3, 4. And just neaten that one up and you've got 5. Anyway, just get the speed. I'm just going to use these 4 for now. And what you do is you braid these together. Now, the best way to do it, to start off a new rope, is, like she says in the video, it's actually quite funny, actually, but to use your toe. So, the reason, see, look, we've got these big long loops. That's 1, 2, 3. Like that. And what you do is, you've got your 3 bits of carrier bag. Make sure you don't get these tied into each other, which is annoying when you do it and it sort of ruins it. But just start braiding it together. Left over middle, right over middle, left over. And you keep doing it over and over and over again. And you get these lovely neat braids. And eventually, like it, you'll end up with something that looks like this. Now I'm going to test and see how strong this is. To put the scales on the tree. Now these scales go up to 50 kilograms and I weigh 111 kilograms. I'm really intrigued to know how strong it is. I opened up Break These Skills because they're actually really good. That is really strong. I was actually pulling it quite tightly then, and that was 15 kilograms. Now I've got to do this properly because it's much stronger than I thought it would be. I think I may have figured out the best way to do this. And I'm stood on the rope and I've got the luggage scales in my hand. I'm going to see now how strong it is. I'm scared it's going to twang off. That's way out of shot already. These are a bit of a give, obviously, because it's plastic. Right, I'm going to get this on camera because I just really want proof of how strong it is. I'm really surprised so far. It's actually sliding under my feet. That's coming up to 20 kilograms of weight already. That is really quite strong. I don't know the best way to do this. I've looped it onto the tree and now I'm going to see if I can get the luggage scales. Oh my god, this is so strong. If anything, my knot's going to give out. Yeah, the knot's giving out more than anything else. That was right up to 22 kilograms.
25?
I've got it to get to 25 kilograms. The only reason why I'm stopping is not because I'm scared of it snapping. It's because of my inability to do this properly and the tree. But this rope, my first attempt, is 25 kilograms. That's really good. It does stretch a little. But that means if you're carrying something, like a big box or something, you could tie this around the box and it'd be easier to carry.
This is really good.
The way to make longer loops is just a case of when you get to the end, just get your other loop, pull it through like that. That's all you do. And you just keep going and going and going until you've braided all the way along. It's very easy. It's incredibly strong. It's a better use than just having these bags hanging around your house. I'm gonna have one more go at trying to pull this and see why I can get 20. Oh, this is actually really strong. Ooh. Yeah, I got to 30. I've got to 30 kilograms that I can pull on this carrier bag. It has stretched a little. I'll unknot it and show you.
Maybe about 2/3.
But all that was really doing was pulling in the braiding a lot tighter. It looks really quite neat, doesn't it, for my first attempt? This is my first attempt one still. And it's incredibly strong. Other uses on the original video that I watched, she had it as a washing line. You could even have it as a very cheap skipping rope, carry bags. You could put a couple of these together and you'd have a good swing rope from a tree.
What else? Well, whatever you use rope for.
Really, really good. I will definitely be braiding carrier bags now instead of buying any kind of rope or string. Scrap, spell me, bye.